as senators led by CIA legislator James Orengo and Elgeyo Marakwet Kipchumba Murkomen today made their team presentation before the BBI Task Force Steering Committee. The leaders want the budget-making process to be included as their role, a recommendation that we see Chapter 12 of the Constitution amended.
The Senate recommends that for the Senate to effectively discharge its mandate under the Constitution, particularly the role of representing the counties and serving the interests of the counties and their governments, it is imperative that the Senate be involved in the budget-making process. The Senate therefore recommends Chapter 12 of the Constitution be amended so as to entrench the role of the Senate in budget-making process, including in the consideration and approval of budget estimates.
The senators are also proposing to be given the mandate to vet several state officers, among them the Director of Public Prosecution, DPP, Director of Criminal Investigations, DCI, among others.
The Senate plays a role of equity, and so approvals of state office holders is very necessary for equitable distribution of positions across the country. The Senate recommends as follows, that all approvals of nominees for appointment to state offices relating to the formation of government or which have direct bearing on the performance of government of the day be approved by the National Assembly, and that approvals of all nominees for appointments to state offices not directly related to the formation of government and which enjoy security of tenure be approved by the Senate.
CIA Senator James Orengo expressed that the rivalry between the two national houses has a remedy if the rule of law will be observed.
The fault lines or the conflict between the National Assembly and the Senate. The Supreme Court said the pivot in terms of the structure of devolution rests on Article 110 of the Constitution. If there can be compliance with just that one article, then you'll find that even that conflict between the National Assembly and the Senate would not arise.
Today's presentation is done by Mental Health Care Task Force, Third Way Alliance and Media Council of Kenya, among others, marked the last day of public participation to the BBI report, even as the committee awaits green light from the head of state and his handshake partner, Raila Odinga. Other senators present during the presentation were Mohamed Faki, Mutula Kilonzo Jr., Ledama Olekin and Victor Prengei, who afterwards presented grievances of the GEC community. Joel Chacha, Switch TV, Nairobi.